Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to share with you some techniques on how to process a cane, like this one. This is the Chesterfield cane that we did in our last video. And actually I want to show you a couple of things. We're going to make a veneer and also one of these beautiful Christmas ornaments. And I'm going to show you how to tessellate the cane, like this one, which is very useful. So let's start by making a simple veneer. Now, to make a good veneer, you first of all need to make good slices. And I usually do that with a slicing tool because it's just so much easier. But today I want to do it by hand because I want to show you that it can also be done that way. And before you slice your cane, you should let it rest, because it's going to be more firm afterwards and it's going to be easier to make clean slices. You could also put it in the fridge for a few minutes if you're in a hurry. It does the same. So I already chopped off the end here and I'm going to make some thin slices. Don't make them too thin, maybe 2 or 3 millimeters. And we want them all to have the same thickness and a constant thickness. And usually before tidying my slices together, I lay them out on a sheet of wax paper. And I will keep the orientation and also I will keep the order. This is not always necessary, but when you work with a tessellated cane, it's helpful because the slices that were next to each other on the cane, they will fit best to each other in the veneer. Okay, and now we can start assembling our slices on another sheet of wax paper. And this is important because we don't want them to stick to our surface, the glass surface. And on the paper, you can still move them to match them up. And we want to match these black lines inside our pattern. And of course, we're also matching the outside shape of the tiles, but the line has priority. So I finished the first row and then I'll keep on down here, and here I gotta match two lines. And I just position them loosely, and I don't mind that gap because we're gonna close that later. Okay, so all my lines are matching and now we can start to press them down and also to close these gaps by pushing the clay together. And we don't have to close them fully because we're gonna do the rest with a tool. And for this tool, you could be using your acrylic roller, but personally I think that rubbing works better. So I'm using this large sculpting tool. It's a ceramic sculpting tool, but it could be any hard object with a smooth, slightly bended surface, like this one. A lot of people are using these metallic paperweights. And we'll put another sheet of wax paper on top of our veneer, and then I'll rub through that paper and I put a lot of pressure. So here I can already see through my wax paper that the whole thing is stuck to my surface and there's no gaps anymore, which means there's no air trapped inside anymore. And to take off this paper, you gotta be a little bit careful. What I do is I leave it on my surface resting and then I pull that paper to the back. and I put it back, position it loosely, turn the whole thing around, and do the same on the back. And now our veneer is free and in one piece. Now there's a last thing we want to do here because it got this odd shape. So I want to make a straight cut here and chop off this side and bring it to the other side. So in the end we're gonna have a rectangular veneer. And you know, you could start from either side, but for your first cut it's important to stay on these lines of your slices. So I can cut here or here or here. If you don't do that, if you cut in between, you're gonna have an offset. So I will just cut here, detach this piece and bring it to the other side, and again match it. And then I'll do the same for the other side. And here actually it doesn't matter where you make your cut. It can be anywhere, it could even be diagonal. So I'll just cut here in the middle somewhere. So here you could see this was actually a little bit difficult to match up all these lines at the same time. So take your time for that, and then we're gonna have to do our rubbing again to close these gaps that we created. And this is our finished veneer. You could run it through the machine to make it thinner and bigger and even more solid. And that's it really. Now, what can you do with a veneer like that? There's basically two main options. You could just bake it as it is. And this is what I do. I'm producing these very large veneers and then baking them and afterwards mounting and framing them like paintings. Actually, they are paintings. And your second option would be to use this veneer, the unbaked veneer, to cover an object and then bake it together with that object. And this is what I did with this Christmas ball here. So the glass is still inside. And unfortunately, you cannot just take the finished veneer and wrap it around this ball. This won't work. Instead, you're gonna have to work in sections. So I prepared this veneer here. It's only three rows of slices that I was tying together sideways, and the length of this veneer is the length of the circumference of our ball. And I already rubbed this to make it into one solid piece that we can also stretch a little bit or compress, so the dimensions are actually don't have to be too precise. And then I'll just take my ball and position it in the middle, and then I'll wrap that sheet around the middle, and hopefully my ends will meet. Yeah, that looks quite good. So I'm stretching a little bit here and order to be able to match these ends, and again match our lines, of course. And now we can start to push these ends carefully onto our surface or glass, and it's going to be compressed a little bit, and we want to do that gradually to make it nice and even. So now we got almost all of our ball covered already. For these remaining areas, you're gonna have to work with individual slices that you tile together on the surface, on the glass. And the pattern is gonna be a lot smaller here and also distorted. So I was already morphing my cane. The rest of my cane, I was making it a lot smaller. So it will fit inside here. And then I will probably do a last row here. And I made the cane even smaller. And also I stretched it a little bit to make it very thin. And it's gonna create a nice star here and also here. And I'm not gonna finish this now because I think you already got the idea. Plus also there's so many good tutorials out there already. So I don't want to repeat that, and instead I want to show you something else. Because what we were doing before with the individual slices in our veneer, we can also do that with an entire cane. So I prepared this new one here with a kiwi themed color scheme, and I was already chopping off the messy ends. This is important. You really want to start with a clean pattern here. And also I was making it quite long, so I can cut it into 4 equal pieces. And these 4 pieces, we're gonna put them together like we did before with our slices. So watch your orientation. And we want to match this line, and we want to match it over the full length of the cane. So I'm putting it together gradually, double checking on the back, and my next piece is gonna go here again, match the line, and the last piece like that. Okay, and now for the tessellation, I will chop off this piece here and put it on the other side. And here again, I make sure to stay on these edges of my cane. So I'll cut here, and on the other side I cut flush on this cane, but be careful not to cut inside this one. And this piece, we're gonna fit it on the other side again, match this line. And now we already have 2 straight sides. And we're gonna do the same for the other side. And here again, it doesn't matter where we cut, so I'll just cut in the middle. But we need to make sure to make a straight cut, so I'll mark the sides. And this again will attach to the other side. Now here we need to match a lot of lines at the same time. If you wanna be very precise, you could also take these pieces apart and match them individually, but I'm just gonna make it into one block like that. And this is our tessellated cane. Now the big advantage of this tessellated version is the fact that you can make the pattern a lot smaller. Of course, you could also reduce the hexagonal cane a lot, make it a lot smaller, but then it's going to be a lot of work to make all these slices and tiling them all together. And here, you already got 4 slices in one tile, and it could be even more. You know, you could also do this with 9 canes or 6 or 12. So you can make the pattern really, really small, which is what I did here with this Christmas ornament. And it looks completely different from the other one. Both are nice, I think, but you know, it's good to have the option. So I hope you learned something. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and thanks for watching.